What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you a 3-day event that I just went to called Guns and Gis. Let's go ahead and dive right in.
Took a quick nap, which was my sleep, and I am all packed up. Let's see, got everything in here, have all my food in there. Back here, I have all my pantry food, I have all my podcast equipment, I have a bunch of computer stuff in there, some necessities for the course, my packing in here, I have a bag underneath there with all the ammo and gear. So I think I did a good job packing. I think I have everything. I hope. Somewhere in Louisiana, I made a pit stop and got a meal out. Salmon and rice, got a new water because I'm out, and we're gonna get back on the road. All right, checked in at the Airbnb. It's super cute. I'll show you guys tomorrow because I had to take care of some things today. But I just got back to Vita Jitsu. So when I first came in here to Louisiana, I went straight here and stretched for a solid like 30 minutes or so, and then went and checked in at the Airbnb, which is perfect. So now I'm gonna go hit up their fundamentals class. They have fundamentals class at 6 p.m. on Thursdays. So I'm here and I'm gonna hit the class. Let's go get our training in for today. All right, just got out of the fundamentals class. It was not really fundamentals though. I felt so advanced, it was awesome. We had multiple black belts in the room sharing just all their tips and coming around and helping us all. And it's like all the little details that you never think about that I'm like, this makes a world of a difference. So now we have orientation for Guns and Gis.
Rachel, right next to Kristen.
Doug, where's our Doug? I'll be your Doug.
Yeah.
We just circle up, everybody introduces themselves, a little bit about yourself, kind of why you came here, your expectations for the...
Check out the swag bag that we got. First Form hooked it up with a bunch of the First Form favorites. Protein bar, this nut butter, which is delicious, and the protein sticks are some of my favorites. Some pre-workout, some hydration sticks to keep us nice and hydrated while we're on the range and on the mats. Greens, oh my gosh, I love the fact that they gave us the travel greens because I'm always traveling. And then Cured Nutrition has some pure CBD oil, a few things in here, there are some beef sticks. And we have our Guns and Gis rash guard right here, t-shirt, and our Guns and Gis. Oh, they put the class number on it. That's cool. The Guns and Gis gi. And then I have my gi that I wore earlier today. So, pretty dope. So you want to know what Guns and Gis is like?
Let me tell you. I am sitting in the morning at the diner on the corner. I am waiting at the counter for the man to pour the coffee.
And he feels it only halfway. And before I even argue, he is looking out the window at somebody coming in.
Hey guys, I'm Greg Lappin. I spent 20 years in law enforcement and military contracting special operations, multiple deployments overseas. I'm currently on a regional SWAT team here. I'm one of their assaulters and explosive breachers. I'm a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt, and I've been instructing firearms in Jiu-Jitsu for about the last 10 years. It's one of my passions, and I can use Guns and Gis camp to give it to other people.
Guys, I'm Greg Anderson. I spent about a decade in special operations and military contracting. Moved on to law enforcement, did another decade in law enforcement, and left that career in 2020, and now we're running this course, Guns and Gis, down in New Orleans, Louisiana. I'm also a check mat black belt and run my own academy up in Lake Stevens, Washington. And we put together this program that incorporates both grappling and the fundamentals of combat pistol shooting.
I'm Joao Assis. I'm Brazilian black belt, third degree. I have been 8 times world champion, ATC champion. I've been a black belt under over a decade, and here we are, Guns and Gis.
Safety is critical, critical, critical today. I can't stress that enough. This is not a race. Don't do anything fast. Think before you move. Take your time. Learn the skills that we're putting out today.
We'll be right back.
firearms training and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. The first thing we started with in the morning was a safety briefing. The most important thing when handling a firearm is making sure that you follow the basic safety instructions. From there, we moved into handling the firearm, doing things like drawing from concealed carry and how to properly hold the pistol, all the basic elements that if you're a beginner you need to know, or if you're an expert, you can improve by even that 1%. It was pretty cool seeing people from all levels being able to benefit from the same instruction.
Hey, my name is Maggie Jouette, and we are from Gonzales, Louisiana. I have never really shot that much before or done jiu-jitsu, so this was really something we decided to do together to step out of our comfort zone, but it's really been eye-opening and life-changing.
Hey, I'm Jeremy. Obviously, we're married. I work in IT for the state. I've done a lot of shooting in the past, but only a couple jiu-jitsu classes prior to coming here, and it's been really great both to have a reintroduction into shooting, but also get some really good fundamentals and some really good stuff on the mat from Coach Joao, or Professor Joao, in the jiu-jitsu realm. It's been really awesome.
In jiu-jitsu, they broke down all of the basic elements of jiu-jitsu, including the different main positions, and I've never had such clear instruction with all of the fundamentals of jiu-jitsu, and it finally started to click and make sense with what was what, so that was a really cool part of day one. On day two, we built upon the fundamentals that we learned on day one. So in the firearms training, we learned what to do when things go wrong with your pistol, with the ammo, all the little things that can happen, and how to properly and effectively get your firearm back into a safe position and also a position where it can actually fire. In jiu-jitsu, we learned some pretty cool things. Learned a lot of chokes, the guillotine chokes. I remember that because my throat still feels it. And we were able to build upon those fundamental moves and those positions that we learned the day before. And we also had a really great time doing some live rolling.
Hey, my name is David Marsh. I work for the City of Cumming Police Department. I'm here with TJ and Frank, who are police officers as well.
And we've been having a great time this weekend going through some shooting drills and some jiu-jitsu drills. We got a lot of trigger time and a lot of mat time. And it's been a great weekend for us to reinforce a lot of basic skills and learn some new skills as well.
A lot of the things we learn are something from way in the past, and we're really set in our ways, so coming to this teaches us new techniques and tactics.
It's kind of cool to be able to train with other people that don't do law enforcement and learn other perspective. And the cadre is super cool, super knowledgeable, so have been great being here.
Day three, for the firearms, we did some close combat style shooting, which was the first time that I've done any shooting like that, and it was definitely, I was a little nervous with that, and that was the first time in the firearms that I felt nerves towards doing something, and it was really amazing how they were able to break it down in a digestible format so that we all felt safe and comfortable and were able to execute the exercise properly and actually feel comfortable doing it. What's up, guys? We are wrapping up day three of Guns and Gis. We are wrapping up the range portion. We still have jiu-jitsu later today, but I really wanted to mention one of the best ways that you can grow is by putting yourself in a situation where you feel uncomfortable. Maybe you're not the best at what you're doing. Maybe you're a brand new beginner. Maybe it's the first time that you're doing this thing. That is where you grow. And here's the thing, it's not an easy thing to do. It's a lot easier to say, hey, be uncomfortable, put yourself in a position of being a student and learning, and it's a lot harder to step into that and to be the one in the room that is the worst at what you're doing. There's that saying, it sucks to suck. Guys, it really sucks to suck. But you just have to understand that everybody starts somewhere. They all had their day one, so start your day one. Stop waiting, stop letting this resistance hold you back from stepping forward into something that you've wanted to do, whether it's join a class like this and learn how to defend and protect yourself and your family, or it's something like a passion or a hobby of yours and you're worried about like how it's gonna go. Stop worrying about it, put all that aside, decide to feel the fear and do it anyways, embrace the suck and understand that every single day that you come in and show up and put in some reps, you'll get better day by day, little by little, and that should be the goal, is day by day, be a little bit better than you were the day before. I am better today than I was yesterday, and I guarantee you with a little bit of practice and a lot of reps, I'll come back better than I was this time at Guns and Gis. So let's go ahead and head to the mats.
Day three in Jiu-Jitsu, we were able to learn how to kind of connect all the pieces, you know? Day one was the fundamentals, day two, learning different movements and angles and takedowns and chokes, and by day three, I felt like everything was flowing so much better than that first day. Overall, Guns and Gis was an absolutely incredible experience. I'm so glad that I did it and stepped outside of my comfort zone, and I highly recommend to anyone watching, if you are looking to train and equip yourself, there has never been a better time, and this is the spot that you want to be. I actually also did a full podcast on this experience. If you're interested in hearing about that, I'll link it as soon as it's live. I'll link it below in the comments and also the show notes there. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you do, don't forget to press a thumbs up. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you guys thought about it, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.